friends, myself and Dr. John from Imperial Institute of Knowledge. Today I would like to talk about Romanticism or Romantic movement. First of all, before starting the topic, I would like to clear the meaning of Romantic. Romantic is not intimate and love scene in a movie or in a book. But the term Romantic was used for the first time in England during 16th century to indicate something unreal and fanciful elements. And during 18th century, it was used to indicate something in contrast with reason but linked with emotion. So we can say that Romantic poetry is a poetry of emotion. And the period which extends from 1798 to 1837 is known as Romantic Age, and the poetry written during this age is known as Romantic poetry. As we have studied earlier, that the precursors of Romanticism like Collins, Cowper, Blake, Burns and Crabbe had already paved the way for the development of Romanticism. And Romantic period began properly with the publication of two lyrical ballads by S.T. Coleridge and William Wordsworth, and The Rime of the Ancient Mariners by Coleridge and The Tintern Abbey by Wordsworth. Well, famous poems were contained in the lyrical ballads published in 1798. So now we will discuss about what led to the Romanticism. There are mainly three reasons. First, Romanticism began roughly around the time of the start of French Revolution in 1789 and finished in 1850. So all the three revolutions are also one of the most important cause of the rise of Romanticism. First, American Revolution, which started in 1775 and lasted in 1793. And after that, French Revolution, which started in 1789 and lasted in 1799. And Napoleonic War, which started in 1796 and lasted in 1800. Second reason, Romanticism was a reaction against the Industrial Revolution. As this age is also known as the Age of Industrial Revolution. And here, to be a romantic is to take the side of nature against industry. During this age, people were being materialistic during Industrial Revolution, and they started ignoring the importance of nature. Peter Aykroyd says, "The story of man's escape from the freedom of from the shackles of commerce and industry to the freedom of nature. In a time the world was becoming increasingly mechanized, the Romantics sought an intense relationship with the natural world. In doing so, they would revolutionize our perception of life itself." And the third reason, Romanticism was also a reaction against Enlightenment, means reason, which was the chief characteristics of presiding movement, neo or pseudo-classical poet or age, which is also known as the Age of Reason. Typically, movement aroused because new generation of writers did not agree with the point of view which preceding movement or preceding age epitomized. Therefore, the Romantic period was a movement which is outcome of the dislikes of the some characteristics of the siding movement. Romanticism is a reaction of neoclassical age. On the following point of view, neoclassical or pseudo-classical age is known as the Age of Reason, while Romanticism and the Romantic age is known as the Age of Emotions and Imaginations. Neoclassical poetry or people advocates reason, while Romanticism advocates passion and emotions, their human nature and their nature. In neoclassical poetry, man over nature, and in romantic poetry, nature over man. Pseudo-classical poet were the follower of materialistic world, while the romantic poets were the follower of spiritual world. Neoclassical poetry was the poetry of aristocratic town dwellers and the people of fashionable class and of intellectual, while romantic poetry was the poetry of countryside people, rustic people, and the common life of emotions and imaginations. Now, I would like to say that Romanticism is also known as the Second Renaissance. Like other great revolutions, it is also a revolt and a revival. It is a revolt against conventional and stereotyped meter, formality and shallowness and self-satisfaction, and all the chief characteristics of the presiding movement. And it was revival to freshness and realism of phrase, to the celebration of the love of nature, to human passion, to a sense of wonder of the world, and to the appreciation of all glories of Greece and Rome, and all of our older literature. Summing up, we can say that, in short, it is reawakening to the liberty of expression free from artificiality and formality. Main poets of Romanticism: William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Percy Bysshe Shelley, John Keats, Lord Byron, William Burroughs, Alexander Pushkin, Victor Hugo, Mary Shelley. First of all, I would like to tell about William Wordsworth. William Wordsworth was much influenced by French Revolution. He spiritualized nature. From 1799 to 1808, he lived at the Dove Cottage in the Lake District of England. Here he became friend with another prominent poet, Robert Southey. Coleridge, Robert Southey, and Wordsworth were the three main figures of the group known as Lake Poets, as they lived in the Lake District. William Wordsworth was appointed poet laureate in England in 1843. And the famous poem of Wordsworth are Daffodils, which was published in 1807, Tintern's Abbey, published in 1798, and The Prelude, published in 1815. Now, S.T. Coleridge. Along with William Wordsworth, Samuel Taylor Coleridge is credited with founding Romanticism movement in England. The two friends broke the decorum of neoclassical verses completely with the publication of Lyrical Ballads in 1798. The publication of Lyrical Ballads is considered a landmark work which changed the course of English literature in England. The famous poems of Coleridge are Kubla Khan, published in 1716, Christabel, published in 1816, The Rime of the Ancient Mariners, published in 1798. Lord Byron. Lord Byron is considered the leading second generation romantic poet. Famous poems are Don Juan, published in 1824, She Walks in Beauty, published in 1818, and Childe Harold's Pilgrimage, published in 1818. Now, Percy Bysshe Shelley, we also know him, P.B. Shelley, was one of the leading second generation romantic poets, and he created some of the best known work of the movement. P.B. Shelley exerted influence on prominent figures as the philosopher of Karl Marx and the Indian freedom fighter Mahatma Gandhi. He is considered one of the greatest poet of the English literature in Romantic Age. Famous poems of Percy Bysshe Shelley are Ozymandias, published in 1818, or To the West Wind, published in 1820, and Prometheus Unbound, published in 1820. John Keats. Along with Lord Byron and P.B. Shelley, John Keats was one of the most important and prominent figure of the second generation romantic poet. Keats died due to the tuberculosis in 1821 at the age of 25. And famous poems of John Keats are The Autumn, published in 1820, Ode on a Grecian Urn, published in 1820, When I Have Fears, published in 1848. Now, William Blake. William Blake remained largely unknown during his lifetime, but he became famous after his death. He belonged to the New Classical age, but he was against conventional diction of the New Classical poetry. And he is also known as the chief precursors of Romanticism. The famous poems of William Blake are The Tiger, published in 1794, London, published in 1794, and Did Those Feet in Ancient Time, published in 1808. Robert Burns was a Scottish poet known as the Bard of Ayrshire and Plowman poet. Burns is widely regarded as the national poet of the Scotland. He is considered a pioneer of Romanticism who had a major influence on the movement. His famous poems are Outlong Shine, published in 1788, To a Mouse, published in 1785, A Red, Red Rose, published in 1794. Among Romantic poets, Wordsworth, Coleridge were much influenced by liberty, fraternity and equality, which were the outcome of French Revolution. To conclude, we can say that the Romantic movement has great importance in the history of England. It was rich in variety. All the form of literature like poetry, drama, prose, criticism and fiction were flourished. It was both a revival and a revolt. It was a great period in the history of Romanticism. Is roughly the period between 1789 and 1850. Second, Romanticism was a reaction against the Industrial Revolution and the Enlightenment. Third, to be romantic is to take the side of nature against industry. The Romanticism disagreed with the Enlightenment values of progress as defined by technological advancement and urbanization. Okay, if you like this video, so please subscribe this channel. Don't forget to press bell icon to get notified, so that you get notified time to time, and comment about the video. And if you have any problem, so ask in comment section.